Hello students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding underarmed and underprepared written by Pawan K. Verma. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 3. Plus this is very, very important from your essay and interview point of view. Now what is this editorial about? And how we can understand and how we can decode this editorial. Now this editorial is basically about the working of the DRDO. It is about the functioning. It is about the potential. It is about the capacity. It is about the capability of the institution, that is DRDO. Defense Research and Development Organization. Now this editorial is also about how this institution has failed the Indian defense system. This editorial is also about how this institution has worked in a way of complacency and procrastination. So in order to understand this editorial, first of all I will be decoding about the nature of the institution, nature of DRDO. By knowing about the nature of the DRDO, we will actually be able to decipher their way of functioning. So for understanding the functionality of any institution, it is always important to know about its nature. It is always important to know about what that institute really stands for. And in order to know that, we need to know about its past, of what it had done in the past, because that will give us a report card of its functionality. And the second thing that I will be discussing will be with respect to the accountability. Accountability of DRDO. Now, before we understand about the nature of DRDO, it is important to know about what all responsibilities were placed on DRDO. Now, this DRDO was created in order to carry out research, in order to carry out development, in order to provide fillip to the defense realm in India. This DRDO was created because India was lacking in defense technology. India was not having the requisite human resource and matter resource in the realm of defense. So this particular organization was created with our purpose, with our goal to stimulate defense production by carrying out defense research in India. So this was the main goal, because when this institution was created in 1950s, at that point of time, India was a virgin land with respect to defense production and research. And at that point of time, India was going through a phase of attrition with China and with Pakistan. And like India has a huge amount of boundary which it shares with the n number of countries. So we have 15,000 plus land boundary with other countries. We have 7,000 plus kilometers of the coastal boundary. Now, in order to protect these boundaries, we need to generate the capacity, we need to generate the ability to fight against our adversaries. So this was the main purpose of this DRDO. Now, till date, it has failed to provide any substantive support to the defense sector. Be that the small arms, or be that the tank system, or be that the missile system, or be that the light combat aircraft, or be that the multimodal aircraft, or be that the aircraft for carrying for the civilian purposes. In all these strategic aspects, DRDO has procrastinated. And why DRDO has failed? So that will be deciphered by its nature of functioning of the DRDO. Now, first of all, in the beginning phase, when DRDO began to perform its function in the 1950s, it is worked on the approach of purist and pompous approach. Now, what is this purist and pompous approach? In the 1950s, 60s and 70s, DRDO was hell-bent on to generate, on to develop each and everything of its own. It was not allowing the government of India to go in for joint ventures with the other countries. DRDO was actually self-aggrandizing itself. It was telling that it will develop everything of what India wants. It will yield the defense production of its own. So there is no need for India to go in for the joint ventures with the other countries to produce light combat aircrafts, to produce guns, to produce tanks, to produce missiles. Everything will be prepared by DRDO. So this was the attitude of the organization in the beginning. And then in the subsequent decades of 1980s and 1990s, it not only continued with this attitude, but along with this attitude, it became quite complacent and it became quite procrastinating. So it was the complacency attitude and the procrastinating attitude. Means it ended up delaying on everything that it had promised in the first phase when it was acting in the purest and pompous way. So pehle promise kiya ki hum ye cheezein denge, baad mein usme there was a lot of delay that was being done by the DRDO. Then we also need to understand why this kind of attitude, ki aisa attitude DRDO ka kaise bana. And in order to know that, we need to understand about the structuring of DRDO, and this structuring will also give us a better idea about how the accountability functions in DRDO. For any organization to work, for any organization to be economic, for any organization to be efficient, for any organization to be effective, accountability is the main thing. Because when you are conferring such a huge responsibility on an organization, it is also important that you must yield accountability from that institution. And how can you yield accountability from that institution? You can yield the accountability only and only by keeping up the mechanisms of control intact. Control hona chahiye, jab control hoga tabhi aapko जवाब मिलेगा, तभी आपको accountability मिलेगी. अगर control नहीं है, the people will not be accountable to you. So in order to make the people accountable, in order to make an organization accountable, it is very important that your control mechanism should work effectively. Now how will that effectively work? Now that thing basically lies in how you would be structurizing your organization. Now, as far as the present director general of this, director of this DRDO is concerned, DRDO, this is S. Christopher. Now, this S. Christopher, he is not only the director of this institution, but apart from being the director of the institution, he is holding some other posts also. He is secretary for the research and development in the Ministry of Defense, and he is also the scientific advisor to the Ministry of Defense. So he is the executive, he is also acting as the executive man, he is also acting as the policy making man. So there is a kind of a culmination that is taking place between the institution of a directorate and the secretarial institution. So this is amalgamation that is taking place. Like for the generalistic administration, we have a district collector, but on the top of the district collector, we have n number of secretaries who are sitting in the secretariat office. So this creates a kind of a control structure. This creates a kind of a hierarchical structure in which you can yield the accountability. But this is not possible here because you have actually not divided the power and the authority. You have actually coalesced the authority, and whenever there is a coalescing of the authority, accountability is least yielded. So this is also one of the reasons of, so apart from these two reasons, there are n number of other reasons why the defense sector has failed to work. So that will go beyond the purview of this lecture. So this is all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. Now, question for the day is, critically analyze the functioning of DRDO. So this is all for the day. In case you like this video, please do click on the like button. Bye bye, take care, have a nice night.